Alrighty, welcome back. It's been a decently long winter and a decently long spring. Incredibly rude. Anyways, the weather was pretty fortunate for us. We avoided the flood. I couldn't be more thankful. But now we've got another problem. Chipmunks. Tons and tons of chipmunks. I left them alone. I noticed the other day they were climbing up and running up in the front of my car and coming out in the back of my car. So they are storing seed. I moved all the seed locations away from the house and put them out further in the woods at 90 and 100 yards. So they're not immediately drawn to the house and into the vehicle. But I'm going to sit on the porch today and I'm going to start taking out some chipmunks at 90 and 100 yards. I may get some, I may miss some. I may get none. Anyways, stay tuned and we'll see what happens. Before I go check this out. June 1st, 41 degrees outside. That's why I'm wearing the getup. Chipmunk out there at 90 yards. I don't know what the hold is off the top of my head. Because I was hitting a few weeks ago at 4, and then I was hitting the other day at 5. So 4.5 would probably be pretty close. Let's put one in the dirt over here and see. See how close we are at 4.5. Let's go for this rock right here. See that little white dot of a rock? Let's try hitting that. So I'll have to watch the wind to make a hold. So let's go 4.5 on that dot. Light wind to the right, so we'll favor the left edge of it. Alright, we hit pretty much at 5, maybe just below 5. Okay, so that was our first official warning shot for the day. The chipmunks have been warned. 5 mil dot hole down there, I'm going to go throw some seed out. We're going to start slaying them. Got 'em. 6. I'll have to range up. That's like 103, 105 yards. Awesome. I'm gonna go check and make sure he's down. Who's watching whom? Squirrels eating all my chipmunk seed. Deer are helping. He's watching. Scraggly looking. Who's in there? Winter fur. Look how fuzzy he looks. Alright. Frickin' red squirrel and I can't shoot him. Thank you.
Alright, let's get rid of that gray squirrel. Let's get him out of there. Oh, wait. There we go. There we go. Come on. Come on. Give me a chance. Let me see your head. I don't know if I hit him. Let's go check. No, it was a miss. He's down there bitching at me somewhere. Alrighty, I've moved the pile closer. It's out at 50 yards. I've cleaned the barrel to get rid of some of the inconsistencies in the pellets. And I'm gonna take a quick zero shot at this chunk of lighter right here. Smidge high, but right on. I'll accept that. I went back and looked at the footage when I shot at that red squirrel. The pellet hit this pole right here. I took a picture of it where you could see the pellet where it impacted. It impacted like right there. Luckiest squirrel ever. Fucker. She's zero and ready. Shot off before Willow got there, but I don't know if I got him. We'll have to see.
I didn't get him with the first shot, but I got him with the second. Alrighty, well, that was the adventure for today. It wasn't a lot of killing, and it wasn't a whole lot of action, but it was a lot of fun. I enjoyed myself. I got to see a little bit of critters running around. It spanned over the course of a couple days because I just had too much going on. I was too busy. I couldn't devote a whole day or a whole lot of time to the gun. I had to get it in passing. So it is what it is. I hope you enjoyed it. I don't remember the count of critters, three chipmunks or whatever, and the luckiest red squirrel ever, but whatever it was, that's the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned. I'm going to get you some more, but I'm limited to 10-minute videos, so we'll see what happens. On to the next adventure. Oh, just over here.